Welcome to new Flutterflow course. Today we are going to start to build a commerce application in Flutterflow. It will be a super course for your e-commerce projects and you will build your app so easy as NoCoder after this course. I want to explain what tools we will use on this course. Flutterflow and Firebase. These two will be our main tools, but we can use additional tools too in next videos. Before the start, if you are not a subscriber, please subscribe and like the video. Thank you. Okay, I already built homepage for this tutorial because there were some bugs on Flutterflow and it took me a lot of time. I didn't want to cut video every time because this could have created gaps in the video. So I decided to explain what I did in project. But when we start to set backend and functions on homepage, we will develop homepage UI and show you every details. So let's begin. We have upside where show users drawer button, app name, and notification icon. We will set actions for these icons. There will be search bar to search product. I use a container and text field, but I think to change it in next episodes. This section will be our announcement section. Users can see campaigns in here. I use a page view for here. Every page has a container and admin can change the background image and customize the design. Next, popular product section. It contains two tags. When you click see all, it will navigate user to popular product page. I use a draw widget for popular product section. When we will finish backend, it will almost look like this, but we will continue to develop UI on later tutorials. Now I want to show you product component. We will have product image and labels here. I use a stack widget because we will add labels on product images and stack provides this feature on projects. I just show you here as an example. We will add there another labels too, but for now just popular label is here. But you also saw 20% label on homepage too. We also have product name, brand name, rating bar, product price, add favorite button, and sliding labels. I want to show you how you can build a sliding labels on Flutterflow without code. We have two labels here. First, we will need a boolean as component state. I am showing you my state here. Second, we will need action. Trigger type will be on initialization. Action type will be loop because it should change every second which we determine for loop. Condition will be the boolean is set or no. If it is set, then it will pass to second action. Our second action will be conditional action. In here, we will need boolean is true or false. First condition will be component state, boolean name. Second value will be true. If it is true, then we use delay action. We will determine seconds in this action. In this example, it will be 3 seconds. Next action will be update component state as false. Component state must change as false because this will show a second label on screen after 3 seconds. Now we will set false path. It will have delay action and just we will update the boolean as true. We have set action path. Now we will set conditional visibilities for labels. Click container. Switch conditional visibility. First value will be our boolean in component state. Second value will be true. We will do same thing for second label and just change second value as false. So your sliding labels are ready. We have categories part here. Normally I use it choice chief widget, but Flutterflow had a bug on this part and I use it many variants for solving it, but it never is changed. So for this video, I use it row and text for now. We will change here with choice chief in next tutorials when we set backend and functions. We have discounts part here and you can see 20% label. I made another components for showing you how app will look like. In next tutorials, we will only use one component and it will be very functional. This course will continue with new tutorials, so if you are not a subscriber, you can subscribe and continue to learn new systems and features. In next tutorials, I will show you more details if I don't get some bugs during record video. If you miss something on video, please don't hesitate and comment below. I plan to set product detail page in next video, so if you can like this video, you will help me to reach more people who can benefit from my tutorials. You can check my website for pre-built templates and finish your apps faster with these templates. I will also set YouTube membership soon and you can join to my YouTube channel as member. There will be special contents for members who support my works. If you think that video helped you a lot, you can send super thanks in below. Thank you for watching and see you on next tutorials.